We need your power. We need your power. We need your glory. Seen in the sanctuary. We need your power. We need your glory. Seen in the sanctuary.
Oh God.
Oh God, God, our God. Early will we seek you.
Oh God.
Oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
We need your power.
We need your power. We need your glory, seeing in the sanctuary.
We need your power.
We need your power. We need your glory, seeing in the sanctuary.
Oh God.
Oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God.
Oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
We need your power,
we need your power, we need your glory, seeing in the sanctuary.
We need your power.
We need your power. We need your glory. Seeing in the sanctuary.
We need your power.
We need your power. We need your glory. Seeing in the sanctuary.
We need your power.
We need your power. We need your glory. Seeing in the sanctuary.
We give you praise.
We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise in the sanctuary. We give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
We give you praise,
we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
Come on, we give you praise,
we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you. Oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
We give you praise,
we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
We give you praise,
we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
We give you praise,
we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
We give you praise,
we give you praise, we give you praise, we give you praise in the sanctuary.
Oh God.
Oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Oh God,
oh God, thou art God, early will we seek you.
Hallelujah, come on and let's give a praise. Come on, hallelujah, we come to bless him. Come on, we come to give him glory, hallelujah. Come on, let's open up our mouths and begin to bless his name. Come on, God, we bless you, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, God, we give you glory,
give you glory. Hallelujah.
God, we give you praise,
God, we give
hallelujah.
You praise, hallelujah.
God, we give you honor, hallelujah.
Come on, hallelujah.
God, we love you.
Oh, we
God,
love
we
you,
exalt
Lord.
You.
We
God,
exalt
God,
you, God.
We exalt you, God.
We exalt you, God.
There is
not like you, God.
Hallelujah. Come on, let's fill this house with praise.
Hallelujah.
Come on, hallelujah. Come on, God, we bless you. We love you.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
We exalt your name.
We exalt your
there
name,
is
God.
None like you in all the earth,
God. No none
God
like you.
Messiah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, there is none like God.
None like you,
come on,
God.
There is none like the God who reigns.
None like
who
you, Lord God.
There is none like
none
the God
like
who sees.
God.
God, we give you glory. Hallelujah. We give you glory, God.
We give you glory.
Oh, yes, 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 yes,
hallelujah.
Yes. Come on, don't stop now. Come on, begin to release
we
your
give you
prayers.
Glory. Hallelujah.
God, we give you glory.
Hallelujah. Glory, glory.
Come on, God, glory, we give glory. You glory. Glory.
Yeah.
be glorified in this place.
Be glorified, be magnified, be glorified in this place.
Come on, be glorified.
Be glorified.
God, you reign. that God reigns.
Oh, God reigns in this place.
Everybody say,
God, you you.
Yes, God.
Oh Lord, we worship you.
Yes, God.
You reign.
Yes,
We worship.
with the 24 elders. Worship Him. 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 Join in with the 24 elders. Join in with the 24 elders. Worship Him. Join in with the 24 elders. Join in with the 24 elders. Join with the 24 elders. Worship Him.
Because He is worthy of all praise. He's worthy of all honor. He's worthy of all glory. Come on, just put your hands in the atmosphere and begin to love on God this morning. Hallelujah. Come on and love on God this morning. Come on and love on God this morning. Hallelujah. Greet your neighbor this morning and tell them Jesus is Lord. Come on, greet your neighbor this morning and tell them Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and give God glory. Come on, He said when two or three, come on. We got more than three folk up in here. Hallelujah. So we're going to come and bless the Lord today. Come on and bless His name. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, as you're greeting your neighbors, hallelujah. Come on, as you're greeting, hallelujah. Good morning. Good morning.
Jesus.
Is lining up with your inside. Because you can have an outward expression and your inside be off. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let me see your inside expression. Y'all must have been in the news Somebody must want something from God this morning. The word was. The atmosphere out there is conducive for alignment. Glory to God. And the remnant shall return. The remnant shall return. Mic right. Come on, mic right just a little bit. Come down a little bit over here. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Just give me a little bit more bass. Glory to God. Hallelujah. How many of you fired up today? Are we sure we're in the right house? His goodness and his mercy and his love. Come on, you're going to let me preach. Come on. Hallelujah. Somebody give God glory. I just came over several different states, so I'm trying to balance. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. We had a powerful weekend. Amen. Glory to God. We're fired up and we're excited about God. Yes, I'm tired, but we're fired up for God. Amen. Amen. And, you know, on my way here, amen, you can be seated. Amen. I was listening to African praise coming here, and I was just got fired up. Amen. So today, amen, what we are going, amen, to talk about, amen, we're going to talk about taking a city and exercising the gate of power. Tell somebody, we're going to take the city. Y'all don't real like it. Look at somebody and say, we're going to take the city. Amen. Whew. You got to let it sit in you for a while. The Lord, amen, was speaking to me. Amen, that we have all these programs going on. Oh, y'all, is this Bible 5 Ministry?
got a lot of programs going on, but nobody's getting souls. He said you're having all these seminars and you're doing all this stuff to get your natural self right. I'm talking about the church. I'm talking about the body of Christ. But God said, what about the souls of the people? We're teaching them how to do things, but their soul has to prosper and be in good health. Amen. So the soul has to get strong. Amen. So God was saying to me, you know, we're doing all these programs to gather people, but we're not winning souls in the gathering. That sounds real straight. Damn. That's not my message. So he was talking to me, but he started talking to me about this decade. The decade. He started talking to me about from year 5780, which is 2020. Everybody knows that, right? Because we're in what, 5784, right? On a Jewish calendar, Hebrew calendar. And he started talking to me to 5790, which is 2030. He started talking to me about these 10 years where we're at and what's going to be going on in these 10 years. Amen. So I'm going to say some things prophetically, and see, your prophet doesn't realize how she's all up in my word already. Amen. Hallelujah. So I'm going to take my time. You mind if I teach today? And if I need to shout, we'll shout a little bit. Amen. But in this season, because God, I woke up and God starts saying, hey. Somebody say, hey.
Hey.
It's spelled H-E-I. Say it again. Hey.
Hey.
That also, it means the number five. Y'all here. It also means mouth, open mouth. Because when you look at the pictorial part of the Hebrew calendar, hey, amen, which is number five, which also is silent, amen. It has it is positioned like this. So hands are raised up and a mouth is open. Y'all hear me? That's the number five. Somebody said that's the number five. So we start looking at this, and so he start talking about five, and then also seven that we know also, amen, deals with open heaven, the seven spirits of God. We all would just go to the completion of it. But remember, we're in a year of 57. So it's going to be 57 all the way up for these next 10 years. And then we're going to change and we're going to move into a new decade. But at this year that we're at, amen, it also symbolizes that we know the 84 is a season of what? Open doors. So there's doors that are open. So you got a mouth open, you got a hand open, and you got a door open. And you got an eye open, because a seven also is IN, which talks about eye. I know I'm giving y'all a little bit Hebrew, but you'll be all right. Amen. Amen. I went to Judaic school, so I should know a little bit at least. Amen. So when you're looking at it, so also talks about the open heaven, the seven spirits, and the seven horns. So we're also in a season of judgment. That is going on even now. How many are aware of what took place in Israel yesterday? I have a friend, everybody know Prophetess Lisa Hicks. She's been in our church many times. She's over there. So she was there, but God called her on an assignment. Amen. When she's over there. And yes, they were, you know, the alarms went off and things. She's safe and everything. So, but God sent her. Isn't it something that God would send a prophet in the middle of a war?
Well.
And we talk about, no, I ain't going. But God usually will send a prophet in war with the people. So she's over there, amen, and she's saying all is well. but also understand that there is judgment is being released all over the land. And it's a season, amen, that the intercessors must rise up like never before. And it's not so much of an outward display, amen. It's good, the intercessors that know how to warn, the intercessors that know how to discern. It's the intercessors that know how to call out unto God and call a people to turn. So as you begin to look at it, amen, we actually are looking at Revelation 5:6. I'm going to ask Jeff to put that up there in Isaiah 11:2, because these are the seasons, amen, that we're in. Amen. And it says, and behold, and I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and the four beasts. And we talked about that. They sang prophetically. And if anyone knows what the four beasts are, they're the ox, the lion, the man, and the eagle, according to Ezekiel chapter 1 and chapter 2. Okay. And in the midst of the elders, and how many elders are there? 24 elders. Amen. Stood a lamb. Who is the lamb? Jesus Christ. Amen. Stood a lamb as I had been slain, having seven horns, seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent forth into all the earth. There is a release, amen, of the seven spirits of God. Go to Isaiah 11:2. And the spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of what? And what? And what? And what? And what? And the fear of the Lord. So this is where we are. Amen. This is where you are. We are. So I'm telling you that we are in a place of great exchange. There is an exchange that is going on. This year is crucial. You shall see some major things beginning to happen, amen, in the earth. You shall continue to see earthquakes, feel earthquakes. You shall see volcano eruptions. You shall begin to see a lot of things, and the weather patterns will continue to change. So none of this should have caught you off guard. Amen. Because we prophesied it. Amen. So even when the earthquake took place a week ago, I already told you on Tuesday we were going to have an earthquake. So none of this should happen. What do you think what happens when I start talking about platelet shifting and gas being released? Talking about fault lines. Amen. So there's a lot of things that are going to happen. Amen. In the boundaries. Amen. And water boundaries. What you're going to see, the water boundaries begin to move. Y'all hear me? So there's a lot of things that been hidden are about to be exposed. I was praying one day and I saw creatures come out of the sea. And I start asking God, what is this? He start talking to me about the spirits that was sent in the ocean. Y'all don't realize when Jesus, when Legion said, for there's, they asked for permission to go where? In the cow, in the pigs, and the pigs went where? God started speaking to me about some things that are going to happen. God did not give us the spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound. And I promise, I pray this is going to be an exciting message, but I don't have enough energy to jump over the pew today. Amen. Amen. So the church is in transition. Tell somebody, the church is in transition. What you seen back then in the 80s, in the 90s, for those of you that have been around like me, amen, hallelujah, when you see the rise of, you know, even earlier the 70s, you know, the 700 Club, and then you begin to see mass churches, you begin to see mega churches coming forth and all that. That is on the decline. I'm not saying it's disappearing, but I'm saying people are looking for churches that they can be touched by. They're coming out of the numbers because they want Jesus. People want to get saved. People want to get healed. People want to get delivered. People need help. They're looking for people who have compassion, people who are going to tell the truth, people who are not going to sugarcoat it. People, they're looking for raw truth, not just truth. They want you to tell it just as it is. If you messed up, tell me I'm messed up. If I'm fornicating, tell me I'm fornicating. I want to give more than my tithes. I want to serve God, and I don't want to serve God jacked up. I want to serve God holy. I want to serve God sanctified. I want to serve God clean. I want to serve God, and I don't want anything in me that's going to jack me up. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. And I want you to know, hallelujah, you can praise God and still go to hell. You can speak in tongues and still go to hell. Only the righteous. Only the righteous shall see God. Those that are in right relationship with him. Those that have allowed God to purge you. Those of us that know how to forget those things which are behind us and press to the mark of the high calling. Those that are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it's the power to save, the power to deliver, the power to set free the oppressed, the blind, and the naked. People are tired of being strung out on drugs. People are tired of relapsing. People are tired of being sick in their body, coming to church with cancer and leaving church with cancer, coming to church with glaucoma, can't see, cataract, and leaving the same way. People are tired. They're looking for the power of God. They want to come in contact with power. The church needs to get its power back. The church needs to get its hunger back. The church needs God, not your program. You can dance and still go to hell. You can sing in a choir and still go to hell. You can usher at the door and still go to hell. God's looking for people that are ready to sell out. For God I live and for God I die. They're looking for people to say to their children, as for me and my household, we shall serve the Lord. You can't stay home while I go to church. You can't stay home while there's Bible study. You can't stay home. We have done a disjustice. We're in churches and our children are at home. What is going on with the house of God? What is going on with the saints that you get filled with the Holy Ghost and your children are going to hell? We grew up with Sunday school. We grew up knowing, hallelujah, that Jesus, amen, was born of a virgin. We grew up knowing about Noah's Ark. We grew up knowing about Jonah. We grew up knowing Abraham had 12 sons. Father Abraham had many sons as Father Abraham. We grew up knowing Jesus loves me. This I know, for the Bible tells me so. We grow up, hallelujah, singing, what side are you leaning on? Leaning on the Lord's side. We grew up knowing what all-night prayer was. You didn't bring your blanket. You didn't bring your pillow. You came to the altar and you cried out. Y'all don't hear me. Y'all don't hear me. We grew up different, hallelujah. We go, hallelujah. You talk about how we grew up? Let me tell you how I grew up. When church came, we went to church, and mama had a bag, hallelujah, a basket that had our dinner in it. We were in church all day long because Sunday was the Lord's day. It was the Lord's day. Hallelujah. You didn't have no option. You got up, you got a good breakfast, and you were out of the door. Hallelujah. Because this was the day the Lord has made. And whether you want it or not, I'm going to tell you what else I grew up as. We be in church, hallelujah, your kids sat with you, not in another pew. So when you act up, your mama had a backhand. Hallelujah. See, y'all don't want to get real, hallelujah. My mom had a hand on her. Before I knew it, I was smacked into alignment. They take their hand, they put it on you, a pinch you. You knew you didn't come to church and you didn't even sit with your legs open. They didn't have to tell you to pull your shirt up. Because if you came like that, you were on the altar. Let me tell you, son, let a minister act up as somebody that was in ministry. You would be on the altar during the whole service. Oh, see, y'all understand. You had to pray during the whole service. And if you you didn't even get up and go to the bathroom because everything was subject. Y'all. The pastor said, get on the altar. You were on the altar. You prayed. And if he didn't think you were ready to get up, you didn't get up. I remember a while ago, Jesse was getting on my nerves. Hallelujah. This is years ago. Not the recent stuff. This one was years ago. We came to church, amen, and it was a youth conference. She was acting a little snotty, and we were doing that. I said, get on the altar. She got on the altar right here. Now, you remember? She was on the altar right here. She would look at me, am I done? I left and left her there. I was getting the rebellion out of her. I was allowing God, hallelujah. See, we don't want that, amen. We don't want, you know, so I said, they can't handle it. They can't handle it the way we were brought up. This generation can't handle it. That's why you're going to hell. You got no discipline. Oh, see, y'all. That's why they talk back to their mama and their daddy, because their mama and their daddy trying to be their friend and not their parent. The Bible says, train up your child in the way they should go, and when they're old, they shall not depart. You don't have no conversation with your child like how they feel. What kind of parenting is that? My mom looked at me and said, you don't got an opinion. None of y'all had that. Mother, that's the way it was, right? It was that way. I know you slapped your kids, so I don't have to worry about it. Slap them still now. Hallelujah. You don't understand. We didn't leave. You looked at your mama wrong, and the next thing you know, you didn't eat in church. Bring a whole meal and sit in the church and eat. We stopping that too. I don't care who it is. Related to me, not. We ain't eating in the church. Sanctuary is the house of God. Oh, y'all gonna get mad at me? It's the truth. Feed your children. Hallelujah. If they gotta eat that bad, you're gonna go in the back and you're gonna clean up your stuff. You leave your stuff. Why we have to go clean up after your children because you didn't feed them at home. I would see if you didn't have no food in your house, but y'all got food. Come to Sunday school, we feed them. Well. Glory, they can get some bagels and they can get some, what they get? They get pancakes and French toast and sausage. Somebody said, well, we don't get no pork, so we start making fresh fruit, grits, and oatmeal. No, the kids eat better than y'all. That's the adults eat that, but the kids eat better. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
Raise a hand. See, back then we had a bus. Even if your mom didn't go to church, you were getting on the bus to go. During the middle of the week, you got on the bus. My mom didn't even know what church we were going to, but we were going to somebody's church. Overseer said he had no bus. He had to walk. Well, you know what? Over, it don't count. He lived down there. All you got to do is walk up here. Oh, two blocks. Come on now. Amen. Somebody give God glory. So this is the season. Amen. I got it out of me. Glory to God. I got it out. It says she got it out. So this season, amen, the church is in transitioning. And God is trying to align the church up. And he's trying, amen, to get his priests in order. Amen. And if you're born again, you're a priest. Amen. Glory to God. You know one thing about a priest don't cuss, but Christians do. Priests don't fornicate, but Christians do. I can look it in the word. Priests were charged what they can do or not. That's why the New Testament said, you are a royal priesthood. So, amen. So now God is looking for intercessors, amen, that will be able to stand in the gap to make up a hedge, because there is a hedge and there is breaches all over the place. You turn on TV, it's nothing but a breach. You go in churches, there's breaches. You have this sister, don't talk to this sister. This brother is sleeping with this sister and that sister and that brother. You got anybody on the keyboard, you don't care that their life ain't right. I'm not saying if they're walking through, because sometimes you got to let them walk through something, because sometimes when they get in ministry, ministry will deliver them. But when you've been in something for 10 years and ain't no change, you allow perverted sound be released. And you wonder why people are fornicating, because what's been playing has. You wonder why you woke up and you depressed, and that's because the person who laid hands on you is depressed. The person you've been sitting under, amen, I don't have no suicidal stuff, amen, but it's a suicide. But there was a time that I had it and I had to get delivered from it. I didn't minister when I was jacked up because I knew I was open portal. So go to Ezekiel 22 and 30. I'm getting somewhere prayerfully. We'll get there. Amen. He says, so this is the year of the mouth. So this is the year that you must open up your mouth and get sound. It's a decade. It's a decade of you finding your voice. If you don't have your voice, you must find your voice and you must utilize your voice in this season. Ezekiel 22, 30 says, and God said, I sought for a man among them that should make up the hedge. Are you one of them? I want you to take this personal. God said, I saw the man that's human, that you should make up the hedge. Tell somebody that's me. And stand in the gap before me for the land. Are you strong enough to stand for the land? That I should not destroy it, but I found none. He said, I found no one to be able to stand in the gap and be an intercessor and pray that I don't destroy it. Are we in that situation today? Are you strong enough to go to God like Moses said, God, your name is on the line. You just can't do that, God. Are you strong enough? How many intercessors we have? Are you strong enough to intercede? Are you strong enough, amen, to carry a burden? The masa of God, the weight of God. Are you strong enough, amen, to be able to allow a load to come on you and you don't cripple under the weight? Are you strong enough to carry somebody's burden until they get delivered? Are you strong enough, hallelujah, to take it and allow them to sit on it and you carry the load to the cross? Are you strong enough? You got to ask yourself, am I strong enough? Am I strong enough to bear the burden that you got? Am I the weak or the strong are to bear the infirmities of the weak, not complain about them? See, when people come to you with their burdens, you go and complain about it instead of bearing it. Isaiah 58:12. He says, and they that shall be of thee shall build the old waste places. Thou shalt raise up the foundation of many generations, and thou shalt be called the reward. And what else? You got to restore the path. How many restorers do we got? Y'all don't hear me. God is looking for people to be able to restore. That means, hallelujah, I got one person standing up. I got two people standing up. I got three. You got to know that you are a repairer, that you are strong enough, hallelujah, to repair the breach. Do you got the tools to repair? You got to know what you made of. I'm a repairer. God's called me. See, you don't want to be called that. Nobody wants that title. What am I? I'm a repairer of the breach. What am I? I'm a restorer of the path that you can walk through on. God's called me to clear the way so you can come. God called me, hallelujah, to be a pioneer so you don't have to go through what I've been through. God is bringing about a shift in the land, and he's bringing forth, amen, a spiritual alignment, and he's putting the earth back into alignment, because I don't know if you know it or not, but the earth is off of its axis, and it's been off of its axis for a long time. Hallelujah. That's just science. But God said that the earth is his and the fullness thereof and all that what? So in this alignment, there is a releasing of a mantle of prosperity, y'all said, on his true church. There is going to be a wave of finances. There's going to be a wave, amen, a spiritual growth. There's going to be a wave of wealth that is going to come to the church, it's going to come on you. It's going to be a suddenly thing. You're going to wake up and you're going to have a suddenly moment. You're going to be broke one day and you're going to be wealthy the next day. Y'all don't hear me. Hallelujah. God can do exceedingly abundantly above all what we can think or what he can ask for. There was a little boy that only had a small lunch, but it fed 5,000. You got to believe God for the supernatural in this season. You got to make sure that you are calling life out of your mouth. It was 5 loaves of bread, 3 fish, or 2? 2 fish. 5 loaves, 2. Y'all read your Bible, bless the Lord. So, hallelujah, because y'all better tell me if I'm wrong, amen. So, 5 loaves, 2. And how many people did it say feed? 5,000 was just for who? And if anybody know anything about church, if there was 5,000 men, how many women was it? 10,000. Oh no, come on. Come on, come on. Hallelujah. If there was 5,000 men, hallelujah, there was 10,000 women right there. Hallelujah. And if there was 10,000 women, each woman probably had 3 children. You better understand, probably over 45,000 people were fed off of that. So you got to know, amen, that there is nothing impossible to God. But listen. When he gave them the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes, the Bible tells us that God took him, Jesus took him, and he blessed them. But after he blessed it, he broke it. That's the problem why you don't get increased. You don't know how to break nothing. So when he broke it, what did he do, prophet? He gave it to who? The disciples. Jesus did not do the multiplication, the disciples did. The problem is when something's in your hand, you're afraid to give it out. So if you don't give it out, you'll never get increase. So God, amen, is in the season of doing multiplication. I'm going to let you know something. I've been minding my own business. Something. Wealth has hit me. If y'all understood, you would grab my mantle. Y'all don't understand something. Lord Jesus. Sister Janine, let me tell you. When you start listening to the principles, she says she ain't running. You better run. That woman of God, that woman got on the ground. God got to humble you when you want something. Listen, I'm going to give you all my testimony, a quick testimony. Lord Jesus, me and my husband, we were going through for a season. And God shut everybody's hand so they couldn't help us. Y'all like, yeah, she gonna tell her business. I'm gonna listen. All y'all EFL in here, you know. I wanna know what was going on with Apostle Pastor Misty, what was going on. And years ago, my husband and I did something foolish. Amen. And we got into a situation because we took a loan for somebody in our name. And it was family. And we assumed that they would take care of it. Well, guess what, Judy? They didn't. that we went through, and there was no way that we could take care of it. And I'm sitting there saying, well, do this. We called an attorney. We did everything that we had to do. It was just so astronomical. I was going to church, and I was sitting in there, and the pastor, the lady who sat next to me was pastor, and she said, what's wrong with you? I was just crying, because I said, I need God to help me. And everybody would say, you know, go to your dad. He's Larry Holmes. He'll give you what you need. God shut his hand. God will shut people's hand that they can't help you, because God needed to prove to me that he was God. So it got, Jeffrey, because you're going to tell our business, it got bad. It got bad. I was like, Lord, how are we going to do this? They were like, they came, the sheriff came out. They're like, look, we're coming in your house and taking inventory of what you got. We're going to sell off. I had my jewelry, my boxing gloves. I had, you know, the medallion with his name and all that on there. And they were like, look, we're going to come. We in Africa, and they coming to the house, and I'm in Africa doing missions. And I said, God, you know, what you want to do something about this? Because so we get home, and it was all, you know, they're ready to come in and do all this stuff. I said, well, listen, we don't have it. We just didn't have it. Do you know they'll auction your stuff off? Oh, y'all know that? So it got bad, amen. So we had a car, so we didn't take care of this car payment. So they came the morning we got up, the car was gone. We said, it was broken anyway, but we said, thank God we had another car. It was just sitting in the driveway, like, where the car? I called them, like, we want $1,000. I said, $1,000, that's all you want. It's $1,000. But I said, it ain't working. So we went on, we sought counsel. And the only way they told us to be able to get out of the financial situation that we were in, and I'm not co-signing this for the church, so don't think I am, they said, you have to file bankruptcy. And I said, what? I said, no. And then they said, you got to go to court. I said, no, they don't know. My pride was so up in the air. I was like, no, you know, I'm lying. I'm going to have Misty Holmes all up in the paper and all this other stuff. And here I am. We have to sit there and file bankruptcy. And I was like, I ain't doing that, God. I ain't doing that. And then I talked to the counsel. They said, well, what you need to do? I said, I don't know what to do. And our counsel was, this is what you need to do. So we listened to our counsel. We did. So we went and did it. It was done. It was over with. And less than, I don't know, 30 days, God restored everything. I listened to counsel, but I learned not to do what I did. Y'all hear me? So we learned not to do what we did, but God put us in this place that was very uncomfortable for us, and nobody could help us. And the only way we had to get help is we went through that system. But God restored us 30 days later. Y'all, I'm only telling you a little bit. So God restored us, and we got things back in line, and we said, we'll never, ever do that again. Well, that wasn't true, because we did it again. So anyway, what I'm saying is that we had something that we never had, because when I left my job to go in, all this was when I was going into full-time ministry. When I left my job, some of my jobs I had, I was getting $75 an hour 25 years ago. I would go to the Hodgman LaRoche and do some things and trainings and diversity things and, you know, working. And I had a very good job. Times that when you be working 40 hours a week. Then God called you into ministry and ain't no salary. Nothing. Because what you're getting, you got to take care of the rent. And then when things start going and you start reaching into his 401 to start taking care of, I'm telling you. I don't even know why I'm over here, but anyway, I pray y'all get something. So I'm helping you. Amen. So I had to go through some things, but out of all this, God start teaching us how to be a good steward over what he has given us. And I'm telling you, you know how I got out of the trouble I was in? I start sowing seed. I sowed. Listen, my husband won't be home. He won't even know. They said $1,000 offer, and I'll be coming with $1,000. And by the time I left, I got $2,000 in my hand. See, I learned how to sow ridiculous sowing because I needed to get out of the debt that I was in. So let me bring you to this place now. So now, amen, we're sowers. We sow. We just sow. So this week, I had a ding, ding. I looked, I said, oh, Jesus, Jeffrey, look at this. 2 weeks ago, I had a ding, ding. I said, I woke him up and my phone went off in the middle of the night, like 3 o'clock in the morning. I said, Jeffrey, look at this. Then I got another ding, ding. It was my Zelle. How did he get my Zelle account? Yes. I had another ding, ding this weekend. Listen, I said, I'm going to sow into my grandchildren. I called them. I said, what's your cash at? Because I'm going to see if they tithe. They are now. I start sowing. We went somewhere else. I said, God, what are you going to do? So I sowed there too. And then what did God do? Ding, ding. People I don't even know. Not the church. So what I said to you, there's this mantle of wealth that is on me. Everything that's been held up has been released. Everything that has been held, everything. Listen, somebody say everything. Everything suddenly blessings, unnamed, just blessings. And then I'm looking at it and I'm looking at, listen, and then my kids start getting blessed. They start getting blessed. Jessica did a thing, and I know I'm somewhere else, but you just need to hear this. But I did this thing this weekend for Simply Saving for Project the Board that I'm on. Amen. And we raised, you know, it's money for people, children with education and literacy and things like that, and adults and literacy. Amen. Organization been alive for 56 years. Amen. So I'm on the board and I did Simply Saver. So I'm looking at Jessica and they do food. I said, Jessica, do you wanna be a part of this? She just finished being a chef. Her table was off the chain. They were like, where's her business card? They start lining up to get to her table. She had a line where others didn't have lines. She had a line. Audrey, help, Prophet Audrey, help her work that table. Business start coming. Listen to this. Somebody walked up to her and said, you know what? I want to work with you. Whatever you need to do, you got a brick and mortar because I want to help you get what you need. The next day, the lady sent the email. Y'all don't hear me. The next day, she got an inbox. Somebody said, can you fly here? Can you come to this state? Oh, y'all. I said, girl, you're going to travel. God going to set it up. She starts saying, well, she got all her. You know what? God said to me, don't help her. Only thing I did is gave her the connection. everything else she did on her own. The only person that can get glory is God. So this weekend, my son launched his clothing line. It's called CAP, C-A-P, constantly applying pressure. It's trademarked so y'all can't steal it. Don't even think about it. Hallelujah, because I make sure some stuff is done. And on the back of it, his first line is, failure is not an option. Sweatsuit. They're connected. So my daughter over there, stand up, Jakima, just released her book. The Prayers of the Righteous. You better know that God is up to something up in this house. Come on and give God glory. Come on and give God honor. I'm missing somebody. Who am I missing? Stand up. They Sean, stand up. He got a clothing line. Who else got, I'm looking at everybody else through here. Who? Oh, Danisha. Come on, girl, get up. She's been doing hair for a long time. She went to, I was upset with her because she went to school and she couldn't do me to, you know. She went back to school to get her license to teach, so I had to get these days. I was pushing to get to her. But guess what? Her beauty school is open. You don't gotta go to Empire. That's done. You go right up there and get your license. Get your training that you need, amen, because she's certified. What am I saying? I'm saying that there is a wealth anointing that has come into the house. Lord Jesus, y'all think I can't preach, Lord Jesus. So God, amen, is releasing prosperity. So when I say something to you, it is a season that you must go and do. It's not the season to linger. Melissa, stand up. Melissa's her insurance business. Come on. She went and did everything she needed to do. Come on. Hallelujah. If you need insurance, you need a broker, you need whatever you need, Melissa gonna be able to meet all your needs. Y'all don't even know what's up inside of her. She can help you with commercial real estate. She can help you with real estate. She can help you with broker's insurance. She can help you get a plane ticket. She can... She got multiple businesses inside of her. Stand up again, Jakima. You need hair care products, you can get them from her. You need skincare, Jamie's not here, she sells skincare. You have somebody that is that you know is pregnant and that's a teen mother and they need help, you can see Elder Judy, she got Rosa Sharon. You know somebody in the nursing home here, mother does all her ministry in the nursing home. Mother, stand up. Don't tell me you can be old and don't do ministry. You can't do ministry. We got K and R. Handyman construction. Whatever you need done in your house, in your business, Brother Robert got you. And the men are getting ready to do something so awesome in the church, I can't even talk about it yet. I can't even tell you yet. Geronimo, I said, I can't tell him Geronimo yet, can I? I can't say it yet. There's things that are going to happen, and it's going to change the face of Southside. Jeffrey, I can't talk about it yet. There's two things we can't even talk about. The studio, we can't even talk about yet. Okay, all right. I just said a little bit, y'all. But that's not the big one. So anyway, I don't care what it looks like, sounds like, God is working things out for our benefit. This is your season. You have to get right with God. Do not be discouraged. God is moving and he's aligning us in this season and he's aligning America. Don't worry about God got America. Tell somebody God got America. But in this season of this alignment, there is an undercovering. God is taking everything that was undercover. He's taking the blankets off. So if you've been dipping and diving, it is a season that your ministry shall be exposed. If you've been doing ministry for money, it shall be exposed. If you've been doing ministry for yourself and not doing it for the glory of God, it shall be exposed. You will see those, amen, that had names go across the nation, you will suddenly see them crumble. Because God is bringing honor back to his house. He's dealing with the double standard inside of the church. You're going to see what's been last to be first. It is like I always say, those who think you have been forgotten, it's your time. Those who feel that they have been neglected, it's your time. Y'all hear me? Those of you that have been denied, it's your time. Tell somebody, go back again. If you've been denied, go back again. You hear me? If they told you no, go back again. So, what happened? Let me verify that. Girl. You're going to believe me one day. You're going to believe me one day. No, I know. So, amen. So what God is doing, amen, I'm telling you that the economy is going to shift again. And it's going to shift for your favor. Somebody say, my favor. It's going to shift. Land is going to be turned over to you. Tell somebody, it's my seat. Go walk on some land. If you want land, go walk on it. Y'all don't hear me. If you want land, go walk on it. Go to Ezekiel 14 and 13. It says, Son of man, when the land sinneth against me by trespassing grievously, then I will stretch out my hand upon it and I will break the staff of bread thereof, and I will send famine upon it and will cut the man and the beast from it. That's where we are. There is famine in the land. Y'all hear me? But we must turn, and God is going to restore your land. Y'all hear me? Because the land has sinned. Why? Because we've been standing on it sinning. So it has went into ground, but the ground is reversing itself. Y'all don't hear me? So there is a season, amen, that you are about ready to bring forth fruit. Psalms 24 says, the earth is the Lord's in the fullness thereof. What else to say? And they that what? For he that founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods, who shall ascend into the hills of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He that has what? He that has what? He that has what? And what else? Who have not lifted up his soul unto, nor sworn, he shall receive the blessing of the Lord and the righteous for the God of his salvation. This is a generation of them that seek him, they that seek the face of Jacob. Understand, the generation of seekers will have clean hands. How many generation of seekers are in the house? He said, if you seek me, you shall find me. This is a season for the generation of seekers, amen, that God is going to purge you. God is going to cleanse you. So when you put your hands to the plow, the work will not be defiled. This is a holy work that is coming forth in this season because, oh, you sinners, you have cleansed your hands. Hallelujah. You have cleansed your hands. The land is waiting for you. The earth is waiting for you. The creation is waiting for you. He said the whole creation travaileth and groaneth even until now, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God to appear. It is your time. It is your season to reap your harvest. God said when you got seed in your hand, he's going to bring forth a harvest. You cannot compromise in this season. Tell somebody, no more compromising. The standard is God's word. You will do business like God tells you to do business. You will not be shysty. You will not be a thief. You will not lie. I'm telling you, don't lie to the government. And listen, you will be a generation that seek him, that seek his face. Oh, Jacob, listen to what I'm talking about. You become a gate when you start seeking God. You become a portal, amen, for God's entry. When I start seeking God, he opens me up and allows me to be a gate. He allows me to have access, and he has access to me. Tell somebody, I'm a gate, I'm an entryway. When you want something, that's why you got to understand, hallelujah, that you, your children's wealth is connected to you. Y'all don't hear me. They got, listen, what's in you belongs to them, but you got to open yourself up and allow God to have access so he can pour inside of you. How many people are a gate? Do you know what it means to be a gate? Do you really know what it's to be a gate? That means to be erected from the earth. And you're able to what? Swing open. And you're able to what? Be an entry point to somebody else. God wants you to be an entry point. People need God, but the only way they're going to find God is by your example. If he be lifted up from the earth, he will draw all men unto him. What does that mean? When you begin to lift God up, your gates swing open and people come in. So when you start opening up your mouth and giving God praise, you extended the gate to those that are not even in the atmosphere. Understand, on the day of Pentecost, when it was fully come, they were not in the building, but they were outside of the building. And when God showed up, the gate opened up. The portal of God opened up and it landed. I'm telling you, the next move of God is depending on you to get into position.
Oh, y'all don't hear me.
The next move of God, Andrea, is dependent on you getting in position. What did he say? Oh, lift up your head, all ye gates. Come on, what did he say? 7, lift up your head, all ye gates. Be ye lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King shall come in. You are a gate. What's your head? What's your position? I want to see your position. Lift up your heads. Your head has to be extended. All ye gates, God is calling you an opening. You are an entry point. And be ye lifted up. What? Open doors, everlasting doors. You got gates and you are a door. Gates and doors are extended, come from the earth. They're erected from the earth. It's not a window and it's not a portal which are suspended. These are erected from the earth. I'm telling you, he said, lift up your heads, all ye gates. Ye lift up ye everlasting doors. And what's coming in? Glory, the King of what? The King of what? So listen, we need to understand, glory is the kabod of God, the weight of God, the splendor of God, the fame of God, the weightiness of God. God said, the King of weight, the King of splendor, the King of fame, he shall come in. When God comes in, his whole kingdom is with him. You are fully complete in God, missing nothing. You have all of what you need. Tell somebody, I'm complete in God. I have the shalom of God. Shalom. Nothing missing. Nothing lacking. You are complete. You have what it takes. Y'all don't hear me. You have what it takes. You have what it takes. You have it. You have what it takes. You have what it takes to get your children right. You have what it takes to get your child safe. You have what it takes. You got what it takes. The King of glory, hallelujah, is ready to come in. Listen. Y'all stay focused, hallelujah. That's why y'all can't get what God has for you. Listen, listen. He said, lift up that gate. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. What did he say? When he comes in, he will take out your enemy. He will take out everything that's been messing with you, your children, your finance, everything that's been coming after your job, the anxiety, the depression. He said, though, he's strong in battle. Why will God come in ready to battle? Because he's ready to come against the hell that's been coming up against you. Prophet, he said, the Lord strong. The Lord strong. Y'all hear me? God is not weak. God is not a punk. He does not punk out. He comes in with strength. He comes in ready to take out the enemy on your behalf. The Lord mighty in battle. Mm-hmm.
again. Lift up your head, oh ye gates, even lift them up. Everlasting doors. You got a door in you that is everlasting. The enemy can't shut that door. The enemy has no authority over your door. You are a door. Y'all don't hear me. Jeff, put that scripture up to 9. He said, lift up your heads, all ye who. He's talking to you. All ye gates. Who's the gate? Put your name in there. Mister, your gate. Daryl, your gate. Robert, your gate. Elder Judy, your gate. Minister Janine, your gate. You are a gate. When you take up this position, the King of Glory shall come in. What's he coming in with? With everything he houses, everything that he possesses. God never comes into you empty-handed. Verse 10 says, who is the King of Glory? The Lord of Hosts. He is the King of Glory. Shout hallelujah. Go to Isaiah 60, verse 1 through 5. Come on. He said, arise and shine, for the light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Who is it risen upon? What do you look like? Listen. Listen. He said, arise. Shine for the light, the insight, the revelation, the illumination. Y'all gotta understand the principles of God. Hallelujah. The teachings of God. Hold on. He said, arise, shine, for the light is come. Your knowledge, that which you were lacking, that which you didn't understand. When the King of Glory, he brings revelation to what you did not know. He brings discernment to what you did not understand. So when you arise, you got discernment. You got perfect understanding. You are the tribe of Issachar. You understand the times and the seasons. Listen, the light has come. Those that walk in grace darkness, they shall see light. Arise and shine, for the light is the glory of the Lord. Listen, where's glory at? The glory of the Lord, where at? It is risen up on you. What does that mean? It comes up. Y'all don't get it. If you have no glory, you can't release glory. God said when he comes in, what is in you spills out. What God got for you, hallelujah, you can't contain it. It is meant for atmospheric work. It is meant to kill demons. Let me tell you how glory works. Hold on. Listen, what is glory? We know it's the weight. We know it's the kabob. We know it's the splendor of God. But glory also is the militant agent of God that fights for you. Glory will kill your enemy. That's all you have to do. When he says stand still and see the salvation, what does salvation come with? Glory. So when you stand and you open up your mouth and you say, hey, there's a release of the fog of God, the F-O-G of God, the fog of God is released out of your mouth and it will slaughter your enemy.
It's a mist. You're looking for the mist to come down. God said the mist is in you. You are an atmosphere shifter. You are an atmosphere changer. When you open up your mouth, glory clears your path. What's been in your way? What's been in your child's way? When glory shows up, glory shuts it down. See, we just think glory is this. Glory. Y'all don't understand. Glory is violent. Moses said, God, I want to see. He said, no man has seen my glory and live. Because when glory shows up, it tells what the enemy tries to put up against you. Are you getting this? Are you getting the fact that you don't gotta say nothing? All you gotta do is breathe. You don't have to say one word to what comes up against you. All you gotta do is. Y'all don't get it. Y'all don't get it. He says, listen. He says, gross darkness. He said, but behold, darkness shall cover the earth. Gross darkness, the people. Somebody say, but. Somebody say, but. The Lord shall what? Take that word upon and say, up on. The Lord shall come upon you, up on you, and his glory shall be seen on me. On me. It's on me. When people be saying you don't look the same, it's glory, y'all. See, you know, you gotta understand, glory has its own presence. Glory has its own atmosphere. Hallelujah. So when I operate in glory, I operate in the violence of God. Oh my God. So listen what happens. And the Gentiles are going to do what? They're going to do what? Who's going to come? Who are the Gentiles? All those that didn't have covenant, amen. All those, amen, that had not been born Jews, amen. All those, amen, the Gentiles, the sinners. You can't say, can anyone say if you don't have presence? Nobody's going to come into the kingdom if there's no presence. The people aren't getting changed on your job because there's no presence. Because when presence comes, conviction comes. Are you holding into glory? Are you releasing it? Because when glory is present, it puts a command on your atmosphere to give you what you need. If nothing is changing in my atmosphere, I must question presence. If you can come in my presence and stay the same, what is wrong with me? Oh, yeah. If you can come in my presence and still cuss, where's my glory? And drink and don't get convicted, what's wrong with me? See, you looking at the other person. It's not the other person. Look at what you are lacking. Look at what is not being displayed in your life. Look at, is your gate open? I want to, see, you be looking and say, oh, look at them. They just don't want to change. No, you haven't changed. Because listen, they will run from you if they don't want to change. But they stay around you because there is no change. If you can keep cussing in my presence, what's wrong with God and me? If you can lie in my presence and don't get convicted, what's wrong with my growth? There has to be a change. Glory changes you. They come in your presence. Lord, I see. You think they're calling you Lord, but they see Lord. They begin to bow and they begin to give reverence to God because you are clothed in glory. You are clothed in the weight, in the splendor, in the fame, in the majesty of God. So what did, so listen. So when glory showed up with Isaiah, what did he say? I'm undone. The prophet said, I'm undone, and I dwell in the midst of a people that have unclean lips. And then God says, who shall go before me? Who shall I send? I'm looking in revival. If you hear me, harden not your heart. Is it you that will go? Is it you that will go? Is it you that will go? I'm searching the whole earth. Purify your body. I'm looking out and I'm looking for a people who will stand in the gap and make up the hedge. I'm looking. My glory is ready. My glory is waiting on you. My glory is ready to be spilled out, saith God. For I am ready to spill out on my people. Will you let me spill out in my tabernacle? Will you let me have free course that I will change a nation and I shall change a people? But I'm looking at who shall I send? Thank you. Of the tears that are coming. Y'all hear me? He said in Matthew 12:34, another parable put he forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed seed.
God has given you seed. But while man slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, that appeared the tares also. So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, Sir, did thou not sow good seed in the field? From whence then we got tares? How many of you see the tares? He said unto them, as the enemy hath done this. The servant said unto them, Will thou then that we go and gather them up? But he said, Nay, lest while you gather up the tares, you root also the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. Don't try to pluck things up, because you don't know the difference yet between a wheat and a tare. In your planting, there is going to be tares. I'm giving you a warning. Gather ye together, let them both grow together until the harvest is at time of harvest. And I shall say to the reapers, gather ye together the first tares, bind the bundles and burn them, but gather wheat into the barns. What am I saying? Separation is coming. In this great harvest that God is doing, you want to choose whose side you want. No more riding the fence. Must be able to discern. The enemy is roaring like a lion. I want you to know. Authority, but he gave it to you so you can execute in this season, because they're going to show up because they don't want glory. The fight is to keep you. So there's no open mouth and there's no exit of what's in you. City. Exercise your gate of power.
Tell me you got power. How many of y'all got power? I want to see you operate in your power. Operate in from your power gate. Because you said you got power. That means there's nothing impossible. Or you can exercise it right now. Whatever's been troubling you, allow the glory to kill it. All that stress that's been on you, all that weight of saying, is God going to do it? He's already done it. You just can't see it because you haven't shifted out of your old atmosphere. He said, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that you shall do also, and greater works shall you do, because I go to my Father. And whatever you ask, see, God's word is either real or it's not. It's either truth or not. I know it's true, but you got to make that decision for yourself. He said, and whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do. And whatsoever you ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Jesus said, if you ask in my name, I gotta do it because I want to give glory to my daddy. Tell somebody greater works. Shake your neighbor and say greater works. Shake your neighbor and say greater works. Tell them greater works, greater works. Tell them you're going to raise the dead. Tell them you're going to cast down devils. Tell them you're going to raise the dead. You're going to bring sight to the blind. Come on, tell somebody, encourage somebody. Tell them three things, prophesy three things to them. Find a neighbor, prophesy three things to them that they're going to do. None of y'all move. I said, find your neighbor, prophesy to them three things what they're going to do. Prophesy. Prophesy to them. It's prophesy time. Nobody came to prophesy to me, look. They sow seed. Look at the baby just came and sowed the seed. She just gave a heat offering, the baby. Somebody give God glory. Jump into your new season. Jump into your harvest. Jump into it. Now you better know that's what you jumped into. Hallelujah. Pick it up. Pick up the bounty. Pick up the bounty. Hey!
I'm expecting my harvest. I'm expecting for revival. You know, I'm ready for revival, y'all. Look at the babies coming. Y'all get back to the babies 100-fold. Glory! Now listen, who's having problems getting the bill paid? Who's having problems getting the bill paid? Girl, you better file the plan. Who's having problems in here getting the bill paid? If you having a problem getting the bill paid, come up here. I mean, I need, come on, come up here. Who else is it? I'm stopping. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No more. Hold on. How many of you had a second guest to come up here? Hold on. Hold on. No, I got to do something that God told me to do. Hold on. Those of you that you know you need something done now, walk, take a step forward. Who came late? Who did my late sit down? If you came late, did you come after them? You can come up the next time. I'll call you up, but I need to do something right now. I got to do what God told me to do. You were late. I'm not trying to be, I got to do what God told me to do. That's why. Huh? I'm going to call you back up, but I got to do something God told me to do. Amen. God told me to have the church sowing to y'all. Judy. Hallelujah. Amen. So we're sowing 200 in each of y'all in the name of Jesus. Glory. Glory. God told me to sow. We're going to break that.
Yes.
What's been on you, we break it. In the name of Jesus. What's been tied on your finances, we break it. Amen. I call wealth to come to you. Right now, in the name of Jesus. The church needs something, so we swing. Amen. So we decree. 200, 200, 200, 200. That's $800. We're going to sow that to you. Amen. Go back to your seats. Now, where was the next ones? Where's the next crew? We're all the head. Listen, all y'all see what I just did. All you gotta do is say, church, give him money, everybody. Thank you. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. We will sow 100 into you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. I'm gonna lay hands on you. that you will bring your bill to the church. Show us how to do this. Amen. Bring your bills to church. And we're going to help somebody out each week. You hear me? We're going to help you out. Now, once you get out of this, if you go back to it, that's on you. Remedy on how to get the people out of there. Get you out of your credit card debt. But you got to be faithful in what I tell you to do. We will take a benevolence offering every Sunday. And we're going to help you pay your bills off with the benevolence offerings. We're paying it. understand that God is trying to do something with the church. God is trying to pour us something. Y'all hear me? So we're tithing into you to get this done. But I'm not going to say tithe because we tithe. We send our tithes to our leader. But we're going to tithe. We're going to take something, the benevolence, and we're going to sow into you.
So I just want to testify, because whatever Apostle is telling you to do in this hour, please follow the instructions. And as God is bringing you out of debt, ask Him to make you a good steward over finances, over everything He puts in your hand. I want to testify because I had a $15,000 debt. You may know about that. Yeah. But anyway, I got an email about a week and a half ago, and it says that we received your payment. I didn't pay anything. So in this moment, God is moving. But just because the debt was taken care of, it doesn't mean that I get less. It means that I'm supposed to continue to steward well what God has already put in my hand. God understood that I didn't have it, and my me not having it wasn't really too much of what I did, but trusting God. God showed me that He is God. He is Jehovah Jireh. He will provide. So whatever Apostle is telling you to do in this hour, follow the instructions.
So if we don't have your bill, I don't care what it is. I'm not looking at all your personal stuff now. I could care less. I don't miss. She said that was the bill that she put on the altar. I think God told us Deuteronomy, it talks about, amen, about the principle that I'm going to give you is in Deuteronomy, and it's going to help to help you get out of debt. And if you follow it, you will be out of debt. You hear me? Quickly. But you have to follow the instructions. Amen. Brother Judy and Brother Toronto, if they don't give you a bill, they don't get no pay. I don't care if it's $1,000. I don't care if it's $400. I don't care if it's $100. I don't care what it is. It's your electric. Don't bring me a gas bill. For those right now, the thing we're doing, don't bring me a gas bill. Don't bring me a car note. Don't bring me a mortgage payment. God told me electric. That's what He told me, electric. Amen. Come on, we're going. This is the Hebrew offering, so yes. Let's put this. You have to know that God is a God. He's a faithful God now. He's faithful. And He's showing you how much He loves you today. Knowing that we got our bills in this church are $9,000 a month. Y'all hear me? The bills in this church are $9,000 plus a month. Just to have the heat on, that's about $2,000 a month. That's the gas. The electric is about $1,500 a month. The mortgage is over $2,000. That's 246. That's not right there. Our insurance, our cell phones, our musicians. I don't get a salary. Our administrations. It's over $9,000 a month to run this church. And Lord knows we don't bring $9,000 a month in here. But God has always been faithful. Hey.
Amen. Glory to God. So we're going to come up and give our tithes and offering. That's a tenth. We're teaching about tithing. We're teaching about seed. And we're teaching about offerings on Thursday night. Amen. Tithing, seeds, and offering. Amen. This was a seed offering. So we gave it. It's a heap offering, actually. It's a heap offering. But I called it seed. Amen. So you gave me seed. So now I'm going to sow your seed into the ground. And once you get seed, you get more seed back. Amen. So come on, bring your tithes and your offerings to the front. Christine, you be looking shocked, girl. Listen, Christine's going to school.
We all got money.
I got money.
You got money.
We all got money.
I got money.
We all.
got money, you got money. We all got money, I got money coming down. Money coming down. Money coming down.
I'm a tiger, you're a tiger. We all are tiger.
I'm a tiger, you're a tiger. We all are tiger. I'm a tiger, you're a tiger. And we all are tiger. I'm a tiger, you're a tiger. And we all are tiger.
We all are tiger.
And we all are tiger. And we all are tiger. Money coming down, money coming down, money coming down, money coming down, money
coming
down.
I got money, you got money.
It's coming. We all got money. I got money, you got money. We all got money, I got money, you got money. We all got money, I got money, you got money. We all got money, we all got money. We all got money, we all got money. We all got money, we all got money. We all got money. I'm living in the overflow. You got money, we all got money. I got money, you got money. And we all got money, I got money, you got money. And we all got money, I got money, you got money. We all got money, we all got money. We all got money, we all got money. We all got money, we all got money. We all got money. Money, we all got money. Money coming down, 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 money coming down.
Let's pay all the bills, can't do. Thank you.
careful.
I didn't keep y'all here. Y'all kept yourselves
yeah.
here.
Oh, so
amen. But I'm excited it's about so God.
More.
Hallelujah. I'm excited. Amen. Now I'm going to get an email too. I'm going to get an email too. Hallelujah. A whole shadow cast over him as he's walking out.
Wait, what? Wait, what?
If y'all want to see it, you can see it.
What?
Amen. Glory to God. So we bless you. Oh, visitors. Amen. Come on. Where's she? Oh, visitors.
Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God a hand praise today. Did we have a good time in the Lord? Hallelujah. Now come part of our service where I always welcome our guests. If we have any guests in here this morning, this afternoon, please stand. Let me see you. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Come on, Revival Fire Ministry. Let's show them some love. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And on behalf of our Apostle Misty right here and our overseer Jeffrey, we welcome you via Fire Ministry. Welcome you to our house. Welcome you to a home, a place of love and kindness. And we enjoy Jesus. And we pray that God will allow you to come back again. Did you receive your bags? Okay, so inside your bag, right, there's a card inside this bag that have a Q code. And this Q code, what you'll do is you use your smartphone and you put it up against it and it'll allow you to open it up. And when it opens up, you'll be able to see where you need to put your name and your address and your phone number and all that stuff, right? And at the bottom of it, it leaves a space for you to either leave a message from how you feel about what happened in church today, or if you want prayer, you can leave that also in the little small box. But that's something for you as a token that we would like for you to return. We love you, and we welcome you back again. Amen. Come on, let's put Revival Fire Ministry hands together. And one last thing before we leave, I just want y'all to know that Revival Fire Ministry is about a good work, and we're not going to come down. And our motto here is what we're going to do. We're going to reach your city,
change a nation and touch the world. Our mission, reach a city. Yes, reach a city. Change a nation and touch the world. Come on, let's put our hands together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Those of you who will see our announcements, check out band, and it will be our announcements, amen. But we're asking, amen, if you have young children and you start sending them to the bathroom by themselves, the ushers are asked to stop them and turn them back to you. The children will no longer go to those restrooms by themselves, so the usher is not being mean, but following instructions. If your children are being brought to the bathroom by themselves, the ushers are told to stop them and tell them to go back. And if you're eating in the sanctuary, they will nicely come and ask you to get up, take your food, and go to the bath. Amen. And we're going to ask if you got toilet tissue. Some of y'all blow your nose with toilet tissue. Tissue. Don't leave nothing in the pockets. Please clean up after you. Amen. There's different things are going around, and we shouldn't have to pick up your tissues. Clean up around you and clean up around your children, because if I find out, amen, you've been here and it's your children, I will call you on the telephone and ask you nicely, please clean up behind your children. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Remember at 11 o'clock, 11:20 on Sundays, there is a continental breakfast for the adults. Sunday school starts at 10 o'clock. Amen. Service starts at 11:30. Thank you for staying late. Women, amen. We dismissed everybody. I already prayed you dismissed. But I want to tell you, we have our WOW conference, trauma unit. I want you to be registered. How many of y'all registered? Register. We need you to register for the trauma unit. Amen. We have all these people coming in. Amen. From the hotel. You be able to get a room? Because the hotel has some extra rooms in for us. Amen. So please, amen, register, register. And we need your help. Amen. Shamir, I've been sleeping on you. I'm so sorry. Amen. But we will try to do something. Amen. But I'm tired tonight. So go, everybody go. Amen. Is that bad? Those of you online, thank you for joining us online. God love you. You're a new member, you know, a visitor. Amen. Go to our inbox, inbox us, and we will reach out to you. Amen. Everyone saved? If you ain't saved, amen. Hallelujah. Those of you who ain't saved, the Bible said online, the Bible said, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. If you recite that scripture and pray, Lord, come into my life, for I'm a sinner, no fault of my own, but the fault of Adam and Eve. But you said, if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus, I shall be saved. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Thank you, Father, for delivering me. Go read, amen, Romans 10 and 9. Amen. Go to our website. The plan of salvation is on the website. Amen. Those of you, amen, you can follow us. Amen. Hallelujah. There's ways that you can follow us on the ministry. We have social media. You can follow us through Instagram, Facebook. Amen. All the other ones. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. So be blessed, and we will see you Thursday.